see between Nami Matsuyama, Chiharu Shida up against Nami Matsumoto and Wakana Nagahara. That's how they reach the showpiece match. Three Japanese pairs in the last four, as you can see. Here's the race to the World Tour Finals. And currently, two Korean pairs leading the way. Baekhyun Lee and Kim and Kong showing the rest a clean pair of heels. Remember, only two pairs from any one country can make those World Tour Finals. Well, 4-1 it is in favour of Matsumoto and Nagahara in their head-to-head. Only victory for Matsuyama and Shida was in the last meeting. In fact, three of the last four matches between these pairs have gone to three games. There's Matsuyama, 25 years of age. She is now ranked at 11. That number two ranking was only last November. Nine World Tour titles have won as a pair, including one in January. That was the India Open, a Super 750. Won the All England last year. Came from 17-10 down in their semi-final yesterday against Fukushima and Hirota. Really was coming back from the dead. First one a tournament together, this pair back in 2017. The smiling fish in Thailand. So, the other side of the net, Nami Matsumoto, ranked at 5. They were number one in the world 4 years ago, reached the last eight in the Tokyo Olympic Games. Nagahara, who's same age as her partner, twice world champions these two, 2018 and 19. Won the bronze in that competition for the last 2 years as well, and they haven't dropped a game so far, albeit couple have been, say, long, but semi-lengthy, longish rallies. But eight games played and eight games won for the number four seeds. Sara Shahaseni of Austria is in the umpire's chair. Sean Sudeo of Trinidad and Tobago is the service judge. Thank you.
gentlemen, on my right, Matsumoto and Wakana Nagahara, Japan. And on my left, Nami Matsuyama and Chiharu Shida, Japan. Chiharu Shida to serve to Wakana Nagahara. Love all. Play.
So here we go then for this all-Japanese women's doubles final. Matsuyama to serve.
Back and forth, critical. You're going to get big Olympic points, big world points, and everybody's fighting for that ranking as well as the title here. So great on defense. You're going to see a lot of counter attack, trying to find that back line. But I think we're going to get a lot of long rallies as well. Oh, what a great cutoff. And you're going to see Matsumoto. She improved her net in coming in. Usually she was a backcourt player, but she's really improved the front court as well.
One thing Matsumoto and Nagahara will be is very patient. Excellent defensive game. And they'll be encouraged by that kind of unforced error on the other side of the net. Excellent judgment. Well, it's being challenged, but I'm pretty sure that Nagahara was right to let this go. No, it clipped the line.
Not by much.
Correction in.
I mean, that's where you just have huge sympathy for line judges. How can you expect them to see that at full speed, one look?
Play.
In fact, it's amazing the number of times that challenges are successful. Nowhere near as many as you might think, which just shows what a good job the line judges do for the most
part. Service over. 4-2.
That was wide.
Service over. 5-3.
Oh, that's out the side. Just mishit that one. Not even close.
Not deep enough. Punished by Shida. Late decision, but a good one.
I felt Shida really comes into the net and puts that extra pressure on, so you know you have to take it back with quality.
Service over, 7-7.
Well, evidence again of Matsumoto and Nagahara's excellent defensive game. Just outlasted their opponents there.
Great attack. Comes across the body on this one. Hard one to defend. Tries to get her right in the backhand. Superb rally. Takes it to the back again. Shot rally. Great defense. Skies it right to the back, but it hits the tape. A little of the net help. Nothing you can do.
Well, nicely placed.
Service over. 9-8. Touched you, yes.
Look it. Saying it touched her. So the umpire thinks it touched.
9-all.
Matsumoto.
Just have to forget about it. The umpire's decision is always final. Pretty experienced umpire as well. Sarasha Hosseini.
Nine.
can't afford to do, Matsumoto and Nagahara, to let their disappointment with that early decision by the umpire start to linger in the back of their minds. It's gone, just got to forget about it. And they're still right in this opening game, albeit a couple of points adrift. That should make them feel a bit better.
Service over, 10, 11.
Very sweetly, Matsumoto.
Matsumoto changes the angle quite often as well. She has that great height. She can clip it down, or she does a lot of high smashes as well on the body. Nagahara puts it into the net.
Matsumoto and Nagahara, but all to no avail. We're still starting to turn the heat up a bit here, Matsuyama and Shida.
Placed.
12, 15.
Matsuyama coming out into the around the head, left that wide open at the net.
Yes.
you know, it's a forehand serve. You don't see many forehands. Probably 99% now are all backhand, but it can be very dangerous, especially on the forehand right there. If she can get that right up that tee, a flat or flick, it's really dangerous. So it's good to see different changes, too. It's not easy because no one's used to the forehand serve anymore. Attack, no messing around.
15 all. Don't know if she was just trying to hit it too hard or what, but that really was a poor shot. Missed by, well, it didn't even land on the green, I don't think.
Too far out the back.
Yeah.
It's difficult in doubles. You always have to be ready. You know, even if the shot's not coming to you, you always have to think, okay, the next one is. You're always moving. So it's still tiring, even if you're not hitting. See how much it bounced in the front of the court, too? Waiting for that opportunity right there. Beautiful play, nice and steady.
16-15.
Again, the high smash. I think they're trying, Matsumoto and Nagahara are trying to bring up the smash. It's a high, deep smash. Matsuyama and Shida, their defense is so good lower, so they're just trying to mix it up. Whoa. Yeah. Awesome defense.
18-17.
Matsumoto found that hole. Redirects it. Flattens it out. A little indecisive there. Thank you.
Good lead. And they're just a couple of points away now. 17. Matsumoto and Nagahara. Certainly haven't been at their best, playing badly, but just doing enough at the moment. Tight first game, though, here in this final.
Too easy of serve on that one.
18, 19.
Shida reads the game so well, comes back out, puts it to the ground.
Just like the men's doubles final, this is proving to be very tight, very tense in this opening game. Put those kind of shots into the net.
Well, Shida did most of the work there, but Matsuyama able to get on the attack, picks the spots.
So, game point for the top seeds. Point they'll need, 22-20. That's impressive for Matsuyama and Shida. 22 minutes on court.
22-20.
Matsumoto and Nakahara playing catch up.
Seconds. Second game. Love all. Play.
Mistakes on the team on the far side, trying to put it to the net, trying to move it away, but Shida and Matsuyama really playing well, getting on that attack at the beginning.
Just got to be a bit careful here, Matsumoto and Nagahara. Obviously very early days in game two, but amazing how quickly it can get away from you. Concentration is a must, and that will help the calls.
Service over. 1-3.
Returning the compliment with the service error.
Play. Chiharu. 2-4.
Well, that's a good mix up. I was thinking that you need to do that wide, outside, wide serve short, and then flick up the middle. So you have those two options. So it's really difficult to be ready for both of them.
Confidence boosting point, that. One of the lengthier rallies that we've had.
Again, with that flick, you're ready. Their defense is so solid. It opens up. It can open up the court, and she knows exactly where to go and put it on the ground.
It's a little careless.
Seats on.
Just as well she called, it was a mile out.
It's difficult sometimes when you're so committed to go to it. You have to dive out of the way.
I think she just kind of lost her bearings and has only had eyes for the shuttle, and at the last minute I said, you know what, May, you don't have to play that. It's wide as well, though.
That one stayed in, found the hole. Matsuyama gets it to the back line, goes cross, 23 shot rally.
So a two-point advantage for Matsuyama and Shida, but too close to call it just yet in this final.
left out the back. Another point.
13-9.
On that one, Nagahara was there, too much into the net, but great patience. Matsumoto, it's coming down on the back line, so she's just waiting for her opportunity. Quick drops down the middle.
Oh, that's nicely done. Needed that badly.
11-14.
Yeah, she comes in nice and straight at the last second. She changes her racket. Mid-court shot, beautifully executed. Shot rally again, just a variety of angles coming from Matsumoto.
Good.
It's out the back.
Oh, it is the fifth one.
We'll have a challenge on that one, though. Let's
yeah.
see. Maybe there's a little bit of a chance. I do think it was sailing out the back a little bit. Wow, that packed a punch.
14-15.
Matsumoto, great angle, solid on defense. Look at that, just trying to counterattack it. Gets a lift for her partner. First one going to get back. No chance on the second.
Every time they get within a point or so, it's like Matsuyama and Shida just kind of extinguish the chance of them becoming a massive threat in this second game, but it's still right there for the taking, potentially. And it's getting a little frustrating now for Matsumoto and Nagahara. Couldn't have done much more in that point, still end up losing it.
Right into her forehand, she knew what she wanted to do with it. She was looking for that open court. Almost took her eyes off the shuttle. Women's doubles, you really have to be patient waiting for that opportunity. You don't want to open up the court. Nagahara with a great cutoff that time.
15-18.
Today. She's really trying to control the match. Great on defense, very patient on attack.
Going to be denied on that occasion. Matsumoto and Nagahara.
...373 kilometers on that one. Well, the altitude here in Calgary, the shuttles are faster. 306 miles per hour is the fastest in the world. 492, but here in Calgary, you can really hit hard.
So, four match points, championship points for Matsuyama and Shida. Court, and they have thoroughly deserved the win. 21-16 in that second game. Maybe you could argue too many unforced errors for Matsumoto and Nagahara, but nonetheless, an excellent display from the top seeds. And they now move into double figures in terms of World Tour titles won.
22-20, 21-16.
Well, they were on today. Matsuyama, great power at the back. But Shida really made a difference, I found. She dictated out on the front court, nice and patient at the back, solid defense, crouch defense, moved the shuttle around, and just one up on them today. Taking the crown, ready to get their cowboy hats.
Terrific performance from the top seeds. Ranked six places below their opponents, actually. And that's now two wins in a row over Matsumoto and Nagahara. Reduced that head-to-head to 4-2. I think it suits them, you know.
Are they different sizes? Maybe.
Maybe.
Or maybe the front and the back. There we go.
So the winner's check in the singles, $31,500. And for the runners-up, just shy of 16,000.
Please congratulate our dance partner, Alex Conner, and all the women, girls, champions from Japan, Libby Otomoto and Shira Shida.
big smiles there for the winners. Deserved. Shida really played well today. I was very impressed. Really took control of that game. Matsuyama also did her job. Nice and consistent.
So coming up, we'll have the mixed doubles between Turi Magalud and Minarikawa and Saito. That's in just a couple of minutes, but congratulations again to our women's doubles winners, Matsuyama and Shida. Welcome back to Calgary and our continuing coverage on finals day of the Canada Open. Time for the mixed doubles, or it will be shortly, and it's a Danish-Japanese contest, which somehow appropriate because we've had Danish winners of the men's doubles and Japanese winners of the women's. So Turi and Magalund of Denmark